Corporate stories now with a focus on initial public offerings. CityCorp Renewable Energy Corporation sets a final offer price for its stock market debut. This would be at 2 pesos and 70 centavos per common share. And Saavedra's firm will seek to raise as much as 5.4 billion pesos from the offering of about 1.76 billion common shares. Offer period begins on May 27th up to the 31st, with tentative listing on June 7th. C-REC would then become the second IPO at the local bourse this year after Oceana Gold Philippines. And to Globe Telecom's fintech app GCash, it reiterated today that it would go public at the right time. It responded to query by the stock exchange on comments made by Globe CEO Ernest Cu to Bloomberg. Mr. Cu, who chairs GCash's parent Mint, had said 2025 is their estimate. Mint was last valued in 2021 at $2 billion. More areas in the Philippines declare a state of calamity due to the El Nino phenomenon. According to Joey Villarama of government's El Nino Task Force, around 374 areas have declared a state of calamity due to the dry spell. These includes the entire Bangsamoro region and 11 Philippine provinces. Damage to agriculture also stands at 9.5 billion pesos. Meanwhile, Villarama says government is now preparing flood control projects and water impounding systems for the coming El Niño, La Niña.
Na po tayo ng El Niño. Ina-expect po lalo na or particularly ng Department of Agriculture na kakaunti na lamang po ang madadagdag sa datos na to, and hopefully po dahil nga nag-uulan na nitong mga nakaraang linggo, maiipsan hindi lamang yung tindi ng init ng panahon na nararanasan natin, kundi mauumpisahan na po natin ang rehabilitation ng ating agricultural lands at saka makakapaghanda na rin po tayo sa paparating naman na rainy season at La Niña.
The extreme heat again raising power demand in parts of the Philippines. The country's grid operator has again placed the power grids of Luzon and Visayas on red alert. Luzon is currently under that alert until 5 this afternoon, then later again at 6 p.m. until 10 in the evening. The Visayas region, meanwhile, will stay on red alert until 9 in the evening. A red alert means power supply is insufficient to meet consumer demand. This, as the grid operator says, several plants remain on forced outage or running on derated capacities. Power distributor Meralco says it has already secured commitments from its customers under the interruptible load program to deload more than 300 megawatts from the grid to ease demand. The Energy Department also urging other distribution utilities and electric cooperatives to do the same. The agency also assures the public it is monitoring the situation.